One of the most recent, hostages you faced, or rather difficulties you faced, was when they put an end to your position, when you'd been appointed by the Conservative government to be
Yes.
head of the beautiful building Housing Committee.
Yeah.
That's not right. And because of an interview, which seems to have been a new low in outrageous distortion, you were asked to leave, whatever. What was that like? What?
Well, actually, that was very disturbing because I thought, whatever the attacks on me, the Conservative Party surely is my place of refuge, and they must see that I'm standing up for the things that they ought to be standing up for. And I was pleased that they appointed me to this commission because
Unusual.
unusual, yes, and it was a difficult commission to advocate for beauty in a world that's dominated by utilitarian architecture. You know, that's tough. And it required a lot of work and a lot of diplomacy. But the interesting thing is that when, as you say, I gave an interview at my publisher's request, I didn't ask for it, to the New Statesman. I thought it was going to be about my philosophy and so on. And they sent this journalist of obviously of animated by a very strong hostility to me, put it mildly, who essentially fabricated the interview from my discourse,
Yes.
and by taking bits out of context, adjusting other bits, and all the usual stuff, but addressing it in effect to the social media mob, asking them, inviting them to join in character assassination. And the effect of it, of course, was the whole press came in on this because it looked like a jolly good story, and the Conservative Party joined in. Instead of, I wasn't even asked to explain. I learned, I was on a train at the time, I learned I'd been dismissed peremptorily by the minister concerned, and that was it. And it was, it was typical of this panic that the Conservatives feel at the witch hunting that goes on the left. They don't want to be the next one. If someone is being scapegoated, you must pick up your own stone and throw it at him. Otherwise, you'll be the next one. It's exactly the same as that I talked about the with letters of
Yes,
denunciation.
exactly. Yes. I remember with one particular of the Tory MPs, I think there were about three Tory MPs, won't name them, but one of them who went for you. And it sort of seemed to me, actually, what it really showed also was the level of Philistinism, actually, because I got the impression, and I mean this with the greatest respect, that I got the impression he didn't quite know who you even were. I'm
Yes.
thinking in particular of
Yes.
Johnny Mercer,
You know,
and talking about intellectualism, so somehow this was a bad thing, you
Yeah.
know.
No, I think he was out of his depth. I didn't follow all the things that were said because it was all too upsetting. But I had the great good fortune that Douglas Murray
I saw.
stepped in and relentlessly interrogated the New Statesman about it until finally somebody managed to get hold of the tape of the interview, send it to me anonymously, and we recognised that I hadn't said any of these things, or what if there were phrases that were phrases I'd used them in a completely different
Exactly.
context. And I think now, I think there will be an apology about it from the paper. I know the editor was mortified by the whole thing, and that's good.
Before we leave this particular topic, I suppose that this is an important part in what we call our culture wars, I guess. It was an important instance of it. I suppose that you could say there would be would have been some sort of victory in the culture wars if they had said, actually, we were wrong, please, we would like you
Yes.
to take it back.
Yeah.
If they did that, would you have taken it back?
I think if it had come at the right time, I would, in order to help them over their embarrassment.
Right,
I
okay.
would I
Very big of
wouldn't
you.
yeah, I wouldn't have wanted it back because the reason why I got these attacks, they'd happened already, is that the architectural establishment is deeply hostile to my being in that position, because they know that I will say the things that they don't want to hear and they don't want the public to hear. Namely, that the kind of templates used in our cities and in our countryside today by the average modern architect are deeply repugnant to the ordinary person. And that's why ordinary people fight their planning battles and prevent us from building. And the architectural schools need to wake up to this, and we need to arm the public against them. And I was going to say that. So they will always stop me saying that.
Yes.
And they'll use any weapon, because this is a huge vested interest with a great deal of money behind it.
Yes.
And a great deal of political connection, especially with the Tory party. And
so were you surprised in some ways, maybe, by your appointment as anyone else?
Absolutely. I thought the Conservative Party had was now must be going through a crisis, because it was insane enough to appoint someone who believed what it ought to be believing. On the whole, the Conservative Party has survived by aiming to be still in place at the next election and doing whatever is necessary to be there.